गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम बैक। आई एम हियर अगेन विद द सेम चैप्टर क्लोथ्स वी वेयर, फ्रॉम विच वी हैव डन फ्यू टॉपिक्स। इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डन व्हाट आर क्लोथ्स, व्हाई डू वी वेयर क्लोथ्स, डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ क्लोथ्स इन डिफरेंट सीजन्स and traditional dresses of different states of India. These topics we have done in the last class. I hope all of you have understood till here. Today I will proceed with the kinds of fabrics we use in different seasons. And from where do we get cotton and wool? From where do we get silk and furs? How should the clothes be kept clean and why? These are the topics we will do today. First, clothes are of different kinds. Okay? Clothes are made of fibers. Okay, children? We get fibers from cotton plants, sheep, and silk worms. We get cotton from cotton plants, wool from sheep, and silk from silk worms. Do you know cotton, silk, and wool? See, look at here. Picture is there. Cotton, silk, and wool. These are called natural fibers. Okay, these are called natural fibers. That means these are grown naturally from plants, we get naturally. But today many fibers are made in factories by machines. Okay. These fibers are called man-made fibers. Look at here. They are also used for making clothes. From man-made fibers we use clothes, for making clothes. What are they? Nylon, rayon, polyester, terulin, etc. There are many man-made fibers. Okay, these are man-made fibers. Many dress materials are made from these man-made fibers. And man-made fibers lasts longer than natural fibers. You know, these man-made fibers last longer than these natural fibers, cotton, silk, and wool. Okay, so we have done this, natural fibers and man-made fibers. Now comes to, from where do we get cotton and wool? So let's start. We will do first natural fibers. Take out your social studies book now and open page number 16. Okay, see, they are written here, from where do we get cotton and wool? We get cotton from cotton plants. Farmers grow cotton plants in the fields. Cotton is picked up from the cotton plants. It is spun into yarn. The weaver weaves the yarn into cloth. Yarn means thread. Okay. Now children, we get cotton from cotton plants. Okay. And cotton clothes are made by spinning and weaving of cotton. Okay. First farmers grow cotton plants in the fields and then they pick the cotton from the plants. And then it is spun into thread. That thread is weaving and by a machine called loom. That thread is weaved by a machine called loom. That cotton is woven. Okay. Then cotton clothes are woven such that they allow good air circulation. That's why we feel very comfortable during summer season, right? In the last class we have learned इन समर सीजन वी वेयर कॉटन ड्रेस, कॉटन क्लोथ्स, बिकॉज दे अलाउ गुड एयर सर्कुलेशन एंड दस दे अलाउ द स्किन टू ब्रीथ इट. सो हाउ वी गेट कॉटन? वी गेट कॉटन फ्रॉम कॉटन प्लांट्स एंड कॉटन इज पिक्ड अप फर्स्ट फ्रॉम द प्लांट्स एंड देन इट इज स्पिन्ड इनटू थ्रेड एंड दैट कॉटन इज देन वूवन ऑन अ मशीन कॉल्ड लूम. ओके, अंडरस्टूड. नाउ नेक्स्ट कम्स टू वूल. वूल कम्स फ्रॉम द फ्लीस ऑफ शीप. द फ्लीस इज कॉम्ब्ड एंड स्पन इनटू यार्न. These yarns are woven into woolen clothes. Now, you can see the pictures. This is the procedure of getting wool. How we get wool? First, what happened? Wool is manufactured by processing the hair of sheep. Okay? The hairy skin of a sheep has two types of fibers, children. The coarse and the fine, of which the latter is used to make wool. We make wool and then these wool is used to make woolen clothes. But what is the procedure? What they do? First, they remove the fleece from an animal. See, he is removing fleece. How they remove? By a razor or simple blade. But these removal of hair from blade, through a blade, it does not hurt sheep. Just as we do haircut, it does not hurt us. In the same way, this process does not hurt the sheep. And do you know this process is called shearing? Shearing. And then after what they do, the hair which they remove, the hair is washed properly. Why it is washed? It is washed to remove dirt. See, the process is giving here. It is been washed. Okay? Dust and grease to remove, they washed. Then, how it is been done? It is done with the help of machines. Okay? Washing is done with the help of machines and this process is called scouring. Okay? After that, the wool is sorted on the basis of length, color and texture. What is the length of the hair which they removed from the sheep? Color and texture, they sorted out. Okay? Then after that, then you know natural color of the fleece is white, brown or black. Have you seen the shape? Yes, it's either white, brown or black. That wool is then dyed in different colors. We get wool of different colors, right, in the market. So they dyed, then after sorting, the wool is dyed in different colors. Okay, then after that, that containers of wool, see, you can see in the picture, are put through rollers to squeeze out as much water as possible to dry the wool. Okay, they squeeze the wool through rollers. It's not possible with the hand, right? So they squeezed through rollers and then the wool is weighed and packed into bales. You can see bale. See, bales. The wool is then packed into bales. So this is the procedure of getting wool. And after that, the clothes, woolen clothes, are made from that wool. Understood, children? Next come to, from where do we get silk and fur? We have learned cotton and wool. Now come to silk and fur. Silk. Silk thread is spun by silk worms. These worms feed on mulberry trees. Silk cloth is made from silk yarn. Now again you can see the picture. This is the procedure of production of silk and this is silk yarn. Okay, so silk clothes are made of silk. We get silk from silkworms. Okay, but how? These worms, silkworms, feed on mulberry trees. Okay, that is the leaves of the mulberry trees. These worms feed on that. When they get their full growth, they stop feeding. Okay, they stop feeding when they get their full growth. And they are ready to spin their cocoon. See, they spin their cocoon. And once the silkworms have spun their cocoon, it's time to extract the silk threads. See, you can see here. When cocoon is formed, it's time to take the silk threads, extract the silk threads. These cocoons are placed into, how they get extract the silk threads from cocoon, children? What they do? These cocoons are placed into boiling water. Okay, first they put cocoons in the boiling water so that it gets softened. Gum by which they are held together, cocoons are held together through a gum. That gum, to soften that gum, the cocoons are placed in a boiling water. Okay, then each thread is then carefully reeled from the cocoon, extract from the cocoon carefully and washed out with soap and water. When the silk threads have been washed, they will be bleached. After removing the thread, that thread will be bleached, washed, and then they get bleached and then they get dried before the dyeing is started. They also get dyeing. Okay, now with the help of spinning wheel, the silk threads are spinned quicker. Okay, and then they are ready for the weaving process. Now when weaving is done, in which the final piece of silk comes together. See, you can see final piece of silk comes together after weaving. Then what happens? Silk clothes are made through these, and silk clothes are very light in weight, and they are very costly. Okay, so you understood the silk production of silk. Silkworms are, we get silk from silkworms. They feed on mulberry leaves, and when they get their full growth, they stop eating and they are ready to spin their cocoon. They form cocoon, and once the silkworms spun their cocoon, what we do? We extract the silk threads. And by how we extract the silk threads? By placing the cocoons in the boiling water, and after that we carefully reeled from the cocoon and washed out, and then they bleached and dyeing started. And after that, it with the help of spinning wheels, they are spinned, and then weaving is done, and after weaving our silk yarn is ready. Okay, so let's go to fur. Furs are taken from animals. The fox, the mink, and the rabbit give us furs. You can see the picture, and you might have seen the furs. Furs fabric is made up of animal hair like rabbit and fox. Okay, they have thick and soft hair on their body. These animals have soft and thick hair on their body, so we get fur from them. Okay, we get clothes. See, now move to leather. Leather is made From the skin of animals. Okay, leather is made from the skin of animals. We get fur also from the hair of the animals, and leather we get from the skin of animals. Leather clothes are made from leather. Okay, and we get leather from the skin of animals. Which are the animals from which we get leather? Cattle, sheep, horses, goats, they give us leather. Okay, from their skin we get leather. The leather is first what we do, the leather is cleaned and then they are made soft. Okay, and then leather is used to make leather products. What are the products we get from leather? Leather jackets, leather purse, leather belt, leather shoes, etc. Many products are there. You can see here, this is the skin from skin of the animals from which we have got leather, and these are the products made from leather. Okay, children. Now, how should the clothes be kept clean and why? We wear different types of clothes, but we should keep our clothes clean. And why we should keep our clothes clean? Wash your clothes with soap or washing powder. Get your woolen clothes dry cleaned. In summer, clothes get dirty soon. They give bad smell. We must wash them daily. So children, we should wash our clothes daily, especially in summer when they get dirty soon due to sweating, right? Clothes should be kept at proper places. We should always keep our clothes at proper places. Woolen clothes should be kept in sunlight. Why we should keep our woolen clothes in sunlight? To kill the germs. Right? We must use mothballs. What is mothballs? Naphthalene balls, you know children, it's white in color. We should keep that mothballs so that insects will not spoil our clothes. Sometimes we see some insects spoil our clothes. So we should use mothballs. And we should fold them properly and put them neatly in our cupboards. We should always keep our clothes properly and neatly in our cupboards. Okay, children. So, we have completed this chapter. Now, take down your homework. First is match the column. Column A, make column. You will make column in your exercise book. Column A, cotton, wool, silk, furs. And under column B, you will write comes from the fleece of sheep, are taken from animals, grows on a plant, thread is spun by silkworms. So you will match the right answer. Okay? Cotton, whatever will be the answer, you will draw a line and match. Okay? Next homework is, take the correct answer. Number one, when do we wear cotton clothes? Choices are winter, summer, rainy. Whatever will be the correct answer, you will just take that answer. Number two, which is not made of animal skin? Belt, jacket, sweater. Number three, which is not a winter cloth? Choices are muffler, coat, cotton t-shirt. So, do it. Number three, complete the following sentences. You have to complete these sentences. Number one, we wear clothes too. You will complete it. Number two, cotton clothes absorb. Complete. Number three, we get silk from. Number 4, wool comes from. So children, I hope you all have, all of you have understood the chapter very well. So complete your homework before coming to school. Thank you.